The Antiquarian Circle offers rewards for the lost coins of Thrace. Come and learn more. The Antiquarian Circle offers rewards for the lost coins of Thrace. Have you come to turn any in?
Antiquarian Circle?
Oh, we are an ancient organization dedicated to the lost secrets and antiquities of Tamriel. The coins of Thrace are our latest focus.
What do you care about the coins of Thrace?
Their coins will be a part of our upcoming exhibition of Thracian relics. In addition, all paying visitors will receive a coin as a souvenir. I must stress the paying part.
Where can I find the coins of Thrace?
All over Skyrim. Travel around. Any shop may have a few. They were once in the hands of a Breton noble called Henri Dubois. Apparently, his family somehow committed treason and was wiped out by the Emperor. But Henri's children escaped to Skyrim. They sold those coins at many different shops to cover their tracks, I'd reckon.
Who else are finding these coins?
Pretty much half of Skyrim, but it's never too late to start. I heard there were hundreds of coins out there. I paid 10 gold for each. But you know what? I'll throw in a little extra for you, if you help me resolve a small problem.
Problem?
There was this night woman who intimidated my prospectors. She tried to scare them away from finding the coins. I don't quite understand why, but I'm pretty sure this mad woman would have killed me if I was not surrounded by the townsmen. Please, you've got to help me get rid of her. I've been fearing for my life since the day this rogue knight barged in.
Where is she?
I heard this knight was last spotted near Broken Tower Redoubt. I reckon she's working with those forsworn maniacs. Who knows what they're plotting? Help me resolve this, and you'll be known to all archaeologists and historians. History will remember you, and, to top that, a heavy pouch of gold. Fame? And gold. After all, they're what really matter in the end, aren't they?
Victory is yours! I submit! No more! I yield! I yield!
The hell? That was a thief?
one's alive! Hold your attack, Carvius! You there! Help us stop these undead!
You look worse than you smell!
You'll die again, all the same. Damn you! Die, you...
Thanks for your assistance, stranger. You handled yourself well. To think... These undead would have gone to any village and attacked the innocents. No one deserves such a gruesome fate.
A man paid me to kill you. He said you're a rogue knight trying to kill him.
Would this man happen to call himself an antiquarian?
He did. He's offering rewards for the coins of Thrace.
A vile scheme concealed by promises of gold. Treacherous villains. I only wish I could have stopped them before any of this happened.
What exactly is this scheme?
This search around Skyrim for the coins ordeal? All it's about is to bring the people to this antiquarian, then have them travel all over Skyrim. As the unsuspecting innocents make their journeys, they also carry a deadly plague to every town, every village in this kingdom.
There's a plague in Skyrim?
Indeed. A magical plague manufactured by the masters of this antiquarian.
How do you know all this?
I learned it from my superior in the army. She's a powerful sorceress who detected the unnatural magic behind this.
Okay. Did I get the plague?
I don't know about you, but the sickly usually show symptoms within a few hours, coughing their lungs out. As for me, I have a congenital condition. My family is very much resistant to magic. Which includes the plague.
All right. What's your plan, then?
I've tracked a powerful necromancer to this fortress. I believe she's one of the villains behind the plague. We have her cornered. Come with me and we'll root out the source of the plague.
All right. I'll help you.
Excellent. Let's move.
Lady Olivia, is this truly wise? This woman came from nowhere.
You've seen how she fights, Carvius. We need her. Besides, the general isn't sending us any help.
But the mistress...
Enough small talk. Here to stop the plague, save the world and bring honor to our motherland.
Of course. It's not
Save
my
your
place
breath for the undead.
The high chair. I didn't mean to sound unappreciative, but do understand. Our line of work requires a certain degree of caution.
We have a visitor.
Well, hey, that's not something you see every day.
A curio.
Watch what you're doing.
Thank you.
I'll earn you!
Doesn't go up there.
Let's go. A necromancer is waiting for us to slay.
Damn her.
How do we break her barrier?
Let's worry about that later. The Forsworn Corporate. She's infected the Forsworn and raised them as undead. Worn out at some point.
What the hell?
In this fight. Now's our chance. Attack the barrier.
Attack the what?
I'm glad we didn't lose you.
What happens now?
We need to hunt that necromancer down. There might be clues regarding her next objective in this room. If we can bring down the barriers. Let's have a look. There must be something we can do. Do you really have to say it in such an ominous tone?
Who are you, exactly?
My name is Livia. I'm an Imperial Prefect. So is Carvius.
I'm with the Imperial Legion, too.
It's an honor to meet a fellow servant of the Dragon Flag.
Is that all there is to you? An Imperial Legionnaire?
Fine. If I want you to help stop the plague, it's only fair that you know who you're working with. My name is Livia, Imperial Prefect, and daughter of Amulius Salvian, the High Chancellor of the Empire.
You risk a lot by telling me your true identity?
You risked more by coming here with us.
Hey, people! If you hadn't noticed, the Soul Gem was shooting spells at us moments ago. There seems to be a strange aura around it.
Yeah, I did notice that. That's why I tried to take it before, but I couldn't.
What's wrong?
All right, more clues. Prisoner.
We should never have let you in.
You need healing, let me help you.
You aren't the traitor? Thank the gods. Thank the gods you've come. Have you killed the traitor's offspring?
Traitor's offspring?
The necromancer who brought me here. Did you kill her?
She escaped before we could attack.
Then it's too late. If she lives, then the undead will destroy Rorikstead.
Destroy Rorikstead? Why?
This necromancer. She thinks our town wronged her. But how would any sane man not turn her in to the law? Please, go to Rorikstead. Stop this necromancer. Save our people. I beg you.
That'd be a coincidence.
Received a telepathic message from the mystic. I like it. She tried to divine the necromancer's location. I received a telepathic message from the mistress. I mean, our legate. She tried to divine the necromancer's location. A malignant magicka similar to the necromancer's is flowing across Skyrim, and it all stems from one place. Rorikstead.
Your legate calls herself the mistress?
It's an alias. Only those high in the Imperial hierarchy know her real name. Not that knowing her name helps me fulfill orders.
Necromancer in Rorikstead too?
No. A malignant magicka like hers flows all across Skyrim. Our legate can't locate her whereabouts.
So Rorikstead is the origin of the plague?
Yes. Rorikstead's villagers will soon fall victims to the plague if we don't act fast.
Alright. If it's the origin, it must have fallen already.
No. According to the mistress's divination, some sort of power seems to keep them from turning for now.
All right. So what should we do?
When we get to Rorikstead, and if the villagers are still alive, we'll have to make a decision. To spare them from certain death by the undead, or to save the rest of Skyrim from more plague carriers. But whichever choice we commit to, there can be no room for doubts.
All right. Oh my god, oh my sword's not... He's not gonna get up.
What do you think you're doing? If you needed space, you could have just said so.
Right. Rorik's dead then.
We have not much to-
What?
There is no escape from death.
I can't go into the inn.
Let's go.
Heard about you and your honeyed words.
We'll do what is right. I know we will. Is the talking done?
Well, apparently we can't go into the inn.
There is no escape from death.
Is it because I fast traveled here? Here we go. The undead fog's coming in.
The surrounding is becoming more and more unsettling.
The plague's power is strengthening in Vorikstead.
Something must have happened. Beware the mists. Something's lurking.
It's the undead! Charging in hordes! Ready your swords!
Protect the villagers! Now, now, now!
Damn you!
Yeah! dead dragon!
Mercy! Save this town!
You will die! Let's finish this!
No, oh, that's not undead. Oh my god.
Fall beneath
oh
me.
My god. Oh my god.
By order of the yard.
Fight! Fight for our survival! We must not die this day!
Getting more bounty in Whiterun.
Arch Acolyte. So that's what I am this time. Perhaps the last. He made me a promise that once his plan comes to fruition and his dreams achieved, he will grant me the safety I longed for. Do I believe him? Should I? Even if it means his plan is one of great injustice, of unimaginable chaos? Young people often struggle with this question, trying to find balance on that fine line that defines right and wrong. But to someone who has run for as long as I had, the only question that matters is how much blood my name must bear this time. Heroes will come for me, and I will be their villain. For this legacy of mine is one of a traitor's.
What the hell? Press E to wake up. Okay, I'm not awake.
Absolutely mad person, trying to face an undead army and a necro dragon all at once. A fool's errand, albeit a brave fool's. But you're safe here, for what it's worth, now that the plague has spread.
Why am I here?
You tried to fight the undead dragon, but it was certain to me that you'd die in that battle. Only one way to save you. I shot arrows at you and your friend, after I coated them in a potion of feigned death. Once the undead saw you're both dead, they lost their interest and moved on. That's how I managed to save you, little hero. Would have to call you martyr instead, if I wasn't there.
How did you survive, then?
I didn't allow the undead to see me, that's how. My potions helped me through this encounter.
Need to find the undead dragons. Danger to everyone.
The undead had been dispersed, but the dragon itself flew in the direction of Whiterun. You better go there soon.
Why'd you help?
Saving Skyrim from a plague that turns all its victims into undead, well, seemed like a good cause to me. Quite fair for me to help the hero.
How's Livia?
The girl from Cyrodiil took the damage much worse than you did, but she has managed. I say you can wake her up now.
Well, thanks for the help, Argonian.
My name is Sleeprise Tree, but just call me Alchemist. Don't expect someone from outside the marsh to understand my name. Go where the path of salvation leads you.
Is the barrel not supposed to be there? Oh my god! I can't get up. No. What the? Press E to wake up. It's not doing it.
Oh, is the talking done?
Wake up. It's time to find that dragon.
The dragon can wait. I just want some peace. Regardless, I've woken up. It's time to get back to the mission. Tell me everything that was going on.
Sleeprise Tree saved us.
The undead dragon flew to Whiterun? By the divines, there's no time to waste. Let's go now.
Yeah, I still can't get up. Okay. Astral papers. Why am I drawing the weapon?
Hey! I
heard a voice from the Soul Gem. An Arch Acolyte.
Arch Acolyte? Curious. I wonder what her role is in this plague. Was there anything else? Anything that can help us stop the plague?
I think the Soul Gem contains more secrets, but they're... I'm not sure. Locked?
Soul Gems are products of magic. It would make sense to seek a mage's advice if we want to do something with the Soul Gem.
Let's go.
Certainly.
Go to Whiterun. Ah. We have a spell. Alteration. Restore Rorik's Dead. Hmm. map mark is gone.